come back to the stream. I guess I can talk a little bit, but no, just don't want to talk too much. Of course, this takes a lot of concentration. This looks really bad right now. I don't know. Yeah, look at this. Let's have a look at this with the normal Metcalf. Gosh, let's hide this for a second. That really helps sometimes with seeing where problems in the mesh are. Also, somehow his chin needs to be way higher. It's like bloop. This whole blob down here. We need to make that bit flatter. Or is trying to get smooth curves in these edge loops. Course, that is the way you get a really smooth geometry as well. Because if these curves are smooth in all three dimensions, they are pretty smooth. I think his neck is way too small. That is why I'm struggling so much. Because you can see this shouldn't curve in that much. What is this? Seems like I disabled clipping there for a second. Wasn't such a good idea. Yeah. Yeah, you might be right there, but faces, man. It's hard. That's yeah, that's it. Like you need to tweak every vertex 100 times until it finally looks right. Just about moving vertices around. Except if you know like how to do it right in the first place, but I don't. Yeah, it just talked. What the heck? I'm in the mood for talking right now, so let's talk a bit. But of course, I won't talk all the time. Of course, concentration. It's the worst. Because every time I change something, something else looks bad. But we're getting there slowly. I don't know, I don't want to put too much work into the head because, yeah, of course it needs to look right, but it is a very small part of your model because, especially in Overwatch, like the heads are tiny. The characters have really tiny heads. Like, let's put this into perspective. This is how it looks. And it is the same with the original models. But you don't notice it because he has a very big head and a lot of bushy hair and yeah. But it's actually the right proportion. Really weird. I will scale his head up a bit anyways. But it looks weird. It looks totally off, like it should be this big or something. But let's keep it a bit smaller. So, now for the hair. Let's study this for a bit. Just see how it looks like. She has very long hair at the back, which is like split into two sections, like the top section and the bottom section, and it also has this central cut. I don't know what is it called in English. And yeah, these stripy bits. Recenter. Maybe we should also work on the beard a bit. That doesn't look that right yet. Needs to be browner. I didn't know he has a very flat face. Maybe we need to extend this out a bit. Ooh. I'm a Cree. I'm a squirrel or something. Squirrel McCree. Yeah. Oh, now this will mess everything up again. No. Why? Well, your mouth is way too wide now. Which isn't positioned properly. Ooh, looks a bit better if I move it a bit more back. That's cool. Yeah, but now we head back here's messed up again. I shouldn't worry too much about that, to be honest, because we will put tons of hair on that, but I don't know. Just want to get it right. Yeah, we could do a meme from that. Squirrel McCree. Something. So. Let's just duplicate this. Make it a new object. Over here. Then I will probably add a solidify modifier with a negative thickness. Ooh. Afro McCree. This is the cool thing about 3D modeling, that you can do everything you want to. So, let's position this right again. Oh, that is hard to see. It should work now. Looks like a monk. Is that we brought? Okay, we will use a positive thickness, but scale was up. Guess that way we can control his hair a bit better. Oops, render view mode. Oh. It looks cool as well, but just wanted to do material view. Let's bring up the image over here as well so that I have the reference to look at. Well, this looks weird. But it's not that hard to fix. You can also, yeah, make this a bit closer to his head. Which isn't that much like in the original, but it just looks better. I'm really surprised how well this goes. It seems like I'm finally getting decent at doing faces and heads and that kind of stuff. Which is, yeah, very hard if you started to it, of course. But yeah, it's getting better. Has he even ears? Not really. Sorry, McCree. You will stay deaf. Okay. Okay, now he only needs his legendary hat. So let's move this over. Face swap. Whoop. And position this. His head seems to make the hair. Bit thinner, so let's adjust that. I think this model might even have more polygons than the original McCree model in the end. Like compared to the game model. Yeah, this is the world's best hat by far. Like right now. It's like a bucket. Perfect bucket. But yeah, this finally kind of looks like McCree, you know? Which is cool. The hair isn't perfect there, I need some hair over here to complement his beard and the front hair. So if I did goes a bit together. Just needs to be longer there. Somehow his eye, somehow his eyes look weird. Whoop. There might be a bit. Too distanced from each other. I don't know. Maybe we could also bring his eyelids a bit down to get that McCree look. Yeah, I could add eyelids, but like at some point, I don't want to add too much detail. Let's change the under settings a bit so that we can see a bit more of his face with his body. But I like that look. It's cool. Yeah. Yes, indeed. Maybe we could make them even a bit more narrow. Make him look a bit angry. That's cool. That looks more like McCree. Yeah, I like it. Let's keep that. That's a nice hat. But he needs some bullets for his hat. Hat. Not hat, but hat, I suppose. Where's my music gone to? There we go. This is not his head, is hat. His head! Gosh. It's not curvy enough. Let's add a bit, little bit of curviness in here. Yeah, that's cool. I think it was a good idea to make this project. I wasn't sure about it because Yeah, characters all don't always go that good. And like in a stream, I don't want to show, hey guys, look at this. This is going super bad. And yeah, but it worked out, so it's nice, very nice. Also, let's use this madcap again. That list of spheres you just selected something from. Oh, matcap. If you go to solid shading and like you can open this with the N key, and under shading there's matcap. By default it's like looks like this. But if you enable matcap, you can like select a certain look, which really helps when modeling, because like here you can see the shape of everything, but like with this you can see it way better. It's I don't really know how to describe it, and especially with the reflective ones, you really see the very little detail in the mesh, which can help a lot. But yeah, I normally use this default one, which is similar to like the real default, but it doesn't have reflections or anything, so just nicer to look at. But yeah, this normal one is this one super handy, because you really see where the faces are facing to, which helps a lot. So let's see, here's two of those right in the center here. Over here and over here. No, that's not an add-on. That was implemented in, I'm not really sure, like Blender 2.6 or something between 2.6 and 2.7, I think. So it's not that old, but not that new either. Let's just put them somewhere on the head. Nobody will notice if we cheat a bit. Except you, because you were here in this stream. while you're watching this on YouTube afterwards. I don't know. Mirror this with the center. I always add an empty that I call center because it's just, yeah, way more convenient than to struggle with that every time. I should probably add that into my default scene as well, using that so much. Let's use a cube for this. There we go. Yeah. Almost everything with the madcap looks really great. Hello, Azui, suppose. Welcome to the stream. So I guess his head is done, except the like transition over here. We still need to do that. Everything else looks very, very nice. So we can hide this again. Oh, he has a beard down here. It's a bit weird. I don't know. Having a beard. Let's actually, I just put that image away, but it has a reference over here that I want to use. So let's go to the head tab. And use this reference. Yeah. Yeah, me too. I pre-ordered it like 3 days ago. and like I constantly just wanna play it. I don't know. It's a game that I'm very excited for. And I'm not excited for a lot of games, so it's quite special. Yeah. It's really fun to test those strategies. I mean, you can counter them pretty easily, most of the cases, but it's just fun. Let's solidify this. Move that up here so that it doesn't split it. I don't know if this works. Doesn't matter that much because yeah. His red coat. Should look pretty decent already. Something looks weird back here. Why is that? Okay. Holy crap. Let's turn solidify off. Just a small detail, but it's quite important. Good tool to do hand painted textures. Blender. Yes, I use Blender personally. It's not that easy to use in the beginning because it doesn't have like a lot of presets, I suppose. But you can do quite a lot with it. I'll take a very short break. I will be back in like 1 minute or something. So, we have some fresh tea so I can fuel myself back up so we can continue. Yeah, tea is the best. Do you guys drink tea or coffee? What do you prefer? For me, it's definitely tea. Let's work on his torso a bit. Yeah, I've been told that 3D code should be pretty nice. But I don't know. I just love Blender, so sticking to that. Does he actually have a second belt? Kind of looks like it. Like a bullet belt with all the tools and stuff. kind of getting quite tired right now. Oh, let's get some faster music to get me going again. Okay, so now he has a toolbar of some sort. See how that looks like. Like he has this grenade that stuns people for a second, and he has his thing where the gun goes in. Okay. And start with these first because they are pretty easy to do. Let's give him three of those. I don't actually know how many he has. Like normally he has just one. It is on a cooldown, but it seems like he has more than that on his little tool belt over here. Almost looks like a laser sword from Star Wars. Like he is the Wild West Jedi or something. Now Disney can copy this idea and monetize it. Let's use the solidify modifier for this one as well. It's just too handy to not use it. Alright, so now there's only like the detail on his chest left, the glove for this hand, and the actual arm for the other one, because that's like a robot kind of arm. Then this knee thingy, the shoes, and then we're done. So, still a lot to do, but we're getting closer. Let's do this one. Since it should take too long. Yeah, kind of. But it's just how it looks like, right? Odds is not really vulnerable, it's quite below that. But yeah, kind of. I'm too lazy to do a new hand now, so let's just copy that from somewhere else. Okay, that's a new one. I wish I had a top view for this. Because it's hard to model a hand without, like, good reference. I mean, everything is hard without good reference. Someone wants me to play CSGO, but I don't even play CSGO. Well. Okay, let's do one finger with this reference. That should go quite well, and then we can, oops, just duplicate it. Oh, that looks awful. Let's get a reference image. Okay, we are using the old one. Doesn't matter that much. And we make everything a bit thinner. This looks super good, and we will keep this. Yeah, of course we will. Does this need to be so hard? Can't it be easy?
Hi, Michi.
You're quite late. Still too greenish. Yeah, my streaming setup is a bit messed up, but I'm not gonna fix that. Why should I? I just don't care. I care about my artwork. And I guess that's quite reasonable. Yeah, this hand is oof. Oof. But don't want to work on it anymore. I'm just done with it. Doesn't look good. I don't like it. I don't want to work on it. So, yeah. I would stop working on it in a second. Oof. Just fixing the major issues. Okay, that's it. For the hands, except I need another one on the other side, so we will add that, and then we are actually done, if I'm not mistaken. Could add some stripes for these leather thingies over here on the other side, but in general. Sure, I will contact Blizzard and they will probably include a chipmunk McCree in the game. Can also add a fast blend shape for that. Which is the Chipmunk McCree value, like I can whoop McCree. Chipmunk McCree. McCree? Chipmunk McCree. So, let's do a chipmunk render. That looks perfect. You know? I don't No. Let's throw that out. I don't want to do the details on the code. Yeah, I won't do the stripes on the back here either. I think we're done. There's nothing that I really want to change. So let's set the cursor to the center and add a circle empty. I like to do that for my render setups. Because that way we can parent the camera to make that visible to the circle. Hide the camera again and use the circle to rotate the model pretty easily. But let's zoom a bit out. Let's reset this and also parent the sun lamp to the circle. So let's do a final front render. Well, not a final one because I will increase the samples in a second. But let's look at him from different angles. The code is a bit weird. Also, the lag is going in too much. So let's structure the bullets a bit more precisely. Because they look a bit noisy. I would call it noisy because they are all a bit scattered, which is not what I want. Okay, let's increase the distance here. Looks a bit better. Okay, let's rotate this further. Yeah, really nice. Okay, let's put this into a nice angle, like not right in front, but just slightly angled. Perfect. And let's render this out. No, I did not. But I could do a stick very fast. I guess 3 minutes should be enough for a simple stick, I suppose. No, I won't do any Blender stuff or challenges now. I will finish this up and then relax a bit because I'm tired. Streaming and modeling at the same time is quite exhausting. But I'm really, really pleased with the result. I didn't think we could do this that well. Wait, let me rotate this a bit. So that it is closer. Of course it looked a bit off. So, and then we can all get pretty excited for Overwatch, I suppose. Because I won't do all the characters, just McCree, because he looks nice and I thought he would work well in Velo Poly style. And he does indeed. By the way, I'm using a bit different technique for this one, which smooths out rather flat faces. So, for example, for this arm, you can't see this edge. That is done by smoothing everything and then adding an edge split modifier, which I think looks nicer because it's cleaner, because you only see the important edges and just has a very cartoonish look to it. Hey, irgendwie LPs. Good evening. So, do you guys have any questions or something to ask or to comment? Because we will end the stream pretty quickly here. Okay. So let's save this as McCree. Alright, so thanks for coming by. Thanks for watching this Overwatch hype stream. I'm really waiting for that game to come out. You need help with the character modeling. Well, I would recommend to rewatch the stream and just see how I approach things. But if you have a more specific question, you might ask that if you want to. I stream for quite a while. I think. Oof. I don't even know. Like 4 hours or something. Might be even longer for the entire character. So 2 hours, 25 minutes. Yeah, that might be 4 to 6 hours, something in between. Yeah, if it's fine, I will end the stream and just answer in the chat. So, I don't need to send my screen over for the entire time. If I need to show something, I can start restream again. But for now, this is done. Thank you for watching. This is the McCree Overwatch character.